Hello, happy Friday. Today we're gonna do an outside video. So here I am in my lovely city of Baltimore, and I thought today we could go on a geometry walk. So we're gonna walk all around the park. I'm gonna show you some areas in my neighborhood, and then if you can do so safely, you can take a walk around your neighborhood or even around your own house and see what you can find that is geometric shapes. So there's 2D and 3D shapes. So let's review those real quick. And then I'll show you some of the geometry figures that I found when I walked around my neighborhood.
So some things that we'll be looking for on our geometry walk are 2D shapes. 2D stands for two-dimensional, and these are shapes that are flat. So here are some examples: circle, oval, triangle, square, rectangle, rhombus, trapezoid, and hexagon. I would also add in here two more common 2D shapes. Are pentagons, which have five sides, and octagons, which have eight sides. This image is from Pearson. We will also be looking for 3D shapes or three-dimensional shapes. These are shapes that are not flat. They have three dimensions. You can hold them in your hands. So we have cube, rectangular prism, triangular prism, triangular pyramid, square pyramid, cone, cylinder, and sphere. Another area of geometry deals with angles. So we have acute angles, they measure less than 90 degrees. Right angles, they measure exactly 90 degrees. Obtuse angles measure between 90 degrees and 180 degrees. And straight angles measure exactly 180 degrees. They look like lines. And how you measure an angle is you measure it by how open it is. And this image I made myself, but the 3D one was also from Pearson. And finally, types of lines. What's not on this image are intersecting lines. They're just lines that cross. Perpendicular lines on the right are special types of intersecting lines. They are lines that cross at right angles. And then parallel lines on the left, they are kind of the opposite of perpendicular lines. They are lines that never touch. So we'll be looking for 2D shapes, 3D shapes, angles, and lines on our geometric walk.
All right, let's go take a walk. On this goalpost here, I see a lot of parallel lines, and then I see a lot of perpendicular lines, which means lots of right angles, and then I also see lots of rectangles. Well, here's a classic octagon if I ever saw one, a stop sign. Here's one of our neighborhood playgrounds, and I'm gonna zoom in. I see the clock is a circle. I found a rectangular prism. So here you can actually see it's decorated all around. Okay, a 3D shape. I'm looking at the tree branches on this tree, and I see so many different angles between all of the branches. It's really pretty. All right, on this picnic table here, it kind of looks like a trapezoid. So if we go up, two, three, and then the ground makes four. Well, this one was easy. I found a few different cones. Okay, another 3D shape. Not geometry related, but in case you wanted to see a squirrel. Okay, back to the regularly scheduled program. So I normally hate these things, but today I'm excited because these little burrs are also spheres. Now they're definitely rough around the edges. They're not smooth like a sphere we might see in math class or anything, but I think for nature spheres, they're pretty good. Here is the bike path sign, and I can see some acute angles right there. Well, here is the flag, definitely a rectangle. And also if you look, each of the stripes are also rectangles. And the blue and white part is also a rectangle. It's pretty. I feel like I should be singing God Bless America right now. Maybe I will off camera. Very excited. The very top here, we have a square pyramid. So the base is square. And then if you can see, it rises to a really tiny point. So again, just that top part. Other than that, we got lots of rectangular prisms stacked on rectangular prisms, stacked on rectangular prisms. A lot of people call it diamond, but again, if you turn it, it's a square. Good morning, Baltimore. I found a triangle. Right here, we have the tree, the stick and the ground are forming a triangle. Ooh, I wasn't sure if we were gonna see one of those. Here's one of my favorite places in my city. This is the pagoda in Patterson Park. Let's get closer and take a look at all that geometry we might find in there. We're closer up, and one thing that I spotted right away is this semicircle or half circle window. Ooh, I also see some obtuse angles right underneath that roof all around. See, all right, here's the base. I see all kinds of rectangles and squares on the door. Parallel lines at the crosswalk and in the middle of the road. This is cool. Check out the cone on the top of that building. Pausing our regularly scheduled geometry walk to show you this array made of bricks. How many are there? How can you tell? All right, back to the regular show. Oh, here we have a cylinder in this lovely, not found in nature, but still found on my walk. And a pentagon. Okay, a pentagon is a five-sided figure, so the top sign, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I want to say all these ducks have some geometric properties, but I don't think it's a good idea for me to get too close. So we'll just say hi. And look, this like sculpture in our park is made up of a bunch of cubes. In Baltimore, we have a lot of row homes or townhouses, and I see lots of rectangles on the top and the doors, and I see some semicircles above the doors and windows. Here's my favorite ice cream shop, and you can see the ice cream cone paintings are not really cones since it's 2D, they're just triangles. Now I want some ice cream. This is a marquee at one of our local theaters, and looking up underneath, I see quite the obtuse angle here. And then I see lots of parallel lines, perpendicular lines, right angles, and a circle. Walking on the sidewalk, I see tons of squares. All right, so in my city, on one of our main streets, we have these decorations hanging from side to side, and I see spheres and cylinders. All right, I found a circle in the storm drain. You can see there's also a bunch of little circles inside this big circle. You might say circleception. Well, at least I said. Can't forget about the parallel lines on our city park benches. I see tons of right angles on these stairs. See, right angle, right angle, right angle, all the way up. Top of the flagpole. Okay, that golden sphere. And then the flagpole is also a cylinder. Well, that was my geometry walk around my neighborhood and my city, so I hope that you enjoyed. One thing I think I definitely learned is that in nature, we're not always going to find very straight or smooth sides. We're not going to find perfect angles, but we can still see things that resemble the perfect geometry that we see in math class, and that's pretty cool. So I hope you enjoy. Again, don't walk outside unless it's safe for you to do so and you have an adult with you. But you can at least even do the geometry walk around your house, or you can even look at some pictures and find geometry in there. So I miss you. I can't wait to see you soon. I wish you well.